passive house takes advantage of one of the most abundant resources that Alberta actually has, which is the sun. So you can see that this house is actually orientated along its east-west axis, and the giant window in the middle there is actually the furnace for the house. So we have phenomenal insulation, blanketing the whole home, all the way underneath the foundation and everything. We also have incredibly airtight building envelope, so much so that there's very little energy needed to heat and cool the home.
Welcome to Green Energy Futures, your guide to the green energy revolution that's already underway.
New homes could be required to be super energy efficient, net zero ready as early as 2030. Brookfield Residential wanted to learn more about building super energy efficient homes, so they set out to build the most energy efficient, most beautiful home they could.
Hi, welcome to the Brookfield Passive House.
There's been a few jaws drop as soon as they walk in. I don't think it's because it's a passive house. I think it's because it's beautiful.
This is the Tesla of passive homes, requiring 90% less energy than a conventional home. It's heated and powered almost entirely by the sun.
We have basically the furnace, which is the big window in the middle. All the glazing is facing south, the windows, right? And then on top of the roof line, we have a standing seam metal roof system, and we have 8 kilowatt of PV. Solar installed up there.
The secret sauce in this passive house is top to bottom super insulation.
It's incredibly well insulated. So if you go piece by piece, you start with the windows. These windows are about R7, okay? And typical windows are about R2. If you went to the wall systems, R45 compared to an effective R18 being required. Roof systems about R55 compared to a cathedral ceiling, which we're required to have R10. So a dramatic difference, so much so that it changes the mechanical in the home.
Even at 2,400 square feet, this home does not have a furnace.
From there, we move to the ERV, or the Energy Recovery Ventilation System. This is in place of a furnace, so the home does not have a furnace. And I don't know if you can tell right now, but it's running, so it's incredibly quiet. And then there's a little toaster up there, or a hair dryer, so that when it is too cold in February, it comes on and does what it needs to do. But these are your lungs, and this is in place of the furnace.
Yes, this home is heated by the equivalent of a toaster installed in line with an energy recovery ventilator. The ERV recovers heat that otherwise would be lost when bringing fresh air into the nearly airtight home.
So 86% of the heat it will recover, so air that we're exhausting from the house will scavenge 86% of the heat on that to warm up the air coming in.
Passive house standards set goals for energy efficiency, but don't prescribe how to do it. This home has one other pretty cool feature we don't see often in North America. It's built out of 4-inch thick cross-laminated timber, or CLT.
CLT product is, you know, it's a great sustainable resource. It's a natural material, and it's the insulation that we've selected. The wood fiber board on the outside is a byproduct of the manufacturing process for the CLT. Ultimately, you get another good environmental story out of that.
This means the interior walls of the home are beautiful solid wood, and almost no heat is lost through the 16-inch thick walls.
This is cross-laminated timber. It is 4 inches thick of timber that's been glued together and laminated together, and it creates the structure of the wall. At the end product, you install this insulation, 9.5-inch layer, plus the 1.5-inch layer, which will give you R45 value of insulation. This wall will be strapped with 3/4 inches of plywood, and then the siding is put on the outside.
The result, a beautiful, super energy efficient home. Doug Owen says code and policy trends clearly point to a future in which homes need to be super energy efficient.
It doesn't matter whether it's Alberta, Canada, North America. Globally, there's a conversation around energy efficiency, resiliency, conservation. I mean, there's a tremendous amount of momentum behind it.
Alberta's no stranger to energy efficient homes, but this one will be one of just a few in Alberta certified to the rigorous passive house standard.
We have to learn how to localize it and create this local industry that's going to really decrease the cost of building these types of homes and build the type of industry in Alberta that not only allows allows us to live efficiently and comfortably, but also creates jobs and economic opportunities for Albertans.
It's undeniably cool to sit in a luxurious 2,400 square foot estate home that is heated by the equivalent of a hairdryer. Perhaps it's the quiet of the home or the warm floors in the basement. The whole place just feels cozy. Want more details? Check out our blog, podcast, and photos at greenenergyfutures.ca. For Green Energy Futures, I'm David Dodge. Thanks in part to zero emission standards in Vancouver, builders there are taking the passive house idea to the next level. The Skeena is an 85-unit apartment building that requires 90% less energy to run. Learn more in our story about this amazing project.